Perfect.
This is I'm Athanasios Poulakidas, and I will speak about bringing platform architectures to applications in the agricultural domain, right? And this will be based mostly in my experience as coordinating lighthouse project in agriculture and in the bioeconomy, DataBio, and being integration manager in an agriculture platform project, also large, very large scale. So I will not give any figures why agriculture is important, but I will acknowledge that there are many activities in this field, right? So there's DataBio, which is focuses on big data more, and is also looking beyond agriculture into bioeconomy. There is IOF 2020, another large project, which is focusing more on IoT solutions and does not give that much focus on platforms for all the solutions, universal platform. Far Cloud, on their hand, tries to build a cloud platform with a strong middleware for agriculture. Smart Agri Hub is a larger initiative. All these are very large, but this is a little larger, but its focus is on a network of innovation hubs, not platforms. AI for You is also a very large initiative. It focuses on AI platform, generic, but it has applications and a work package on agriculture. And then there are Demeter and Atlas, new projects, which are building agricultural digital integration platforms. And in the rest of this talk, I will talk about DataBio and Demeter, where I served as a coordinator of DataBio and as integration manager in Demeter. Okay, so DataBio was a lighthouse project in big data with 27 pilots and one virtual, with a lot of partners, and it ended by the end of, successfully ended by the end of 2019. So there we had pilots in agriculture, forestry, fishery, and so we had a number of very different requirements and data which we had to handle, and we had to find common ways of how to manage this data and offer the data processing frameworks in order to build the data analytics solutions and, where needed, advanced data visualization solutions. And these are to support the goals, which were to increase the production and have more responsible and sustainable production. And of course, the pilots were used to validate the solutions. Then we have, there are these three pillars of DataBio, which the pilots, the datasets, because it's a big data project, datasets are very important, and the big data components, the big data solutions. And as you can see on the right-hand side, these are being arranged according to the BDVA, Big Data Value Association Reference Model. And since the main authors of this reference model were part of DataBio, we had a two-way interaction with this model. So you can see the infrastructure, the management, data processing, data analytics, visualization. As we say, the focus here is on big data and more than IoT or other kind of domains. I will turn off the video for bandwidth reasons. So the DataBio platform offers the resources to develop your application, right? And the main thing this offers is through the website, you get the knowledge base, let's say roughly. And through the DataBio Hub site, you get the catalog of solutions. So you get the components, pipelines of components, data sets and pilots linked together with a graph, dependency graph. And then you get from several sources the actual images to deploy Docker or whatever to build your solutions and deploy them, right? And although I present here and I was the coordinator of the project, I have to mention that the platform activity was led by VTT. And here is a view of the components used in data bio. So agriculture is here, down there. So on the outer perimeter, you see components which are specific for a few pilots. In the inner cycle, there are components which are used across agriculture pilots. And here there are components which are used not only in agriculture, but other forestry and fishery pilots. And there are, we have also in agriculture a very big part of the solutions have to do with earth observation data, right? So are very specific. And also we, as part of architecture, we identify 25 pipelines of data collection, data preparation, analytics, and visualization. And several of them were found to be generic, that means they're applicable in more than one cases. So you see here the example of the IoT pipeline and one instantiation of this pipeline for one pilot using particular, for example, firmware and IBM, Proton, and other kinds of components. Then I will talk about this. I'm switching project now. I'm talking about another Demeter experience, which is for agriculture pilots, 20 pilots in agriculture, 60 partners, right? This project started in September last year. And the main elements of Demeter are these three spaces, four spaces. On the left-hand side is the space where farmers or providers, service providers are coming to select and compile and discuss their solutions that fits their needs. It's a collaboration space. On the right hand side is the space, the development space, where all solutions are made interoperable and are made available to be used from the technology point of view. In the middle is the enabler hub where all these are being cataloged and being available to be used. It's a marketplace with more advanced features. And at the top is, you know, the dashboard, which provides a uniform access to all these three elements, main elements below. Okay. The building blocks are very simple. So we have as a building block the Demeter enhanced entity, which is a on top of each platform think service application, the architect selects where you apply. You apply the this wrapper, this enabler interface, let's say, where you are exposed either as a Demeter provider or consumer or both. And you have to implement functionality from some core enablers and some optional enablers. The second building block is the agricultural information model, which is a common data semantic model. So you talk the same language. And this is the reference architecture, how it looks from when you deploy it. So on the bottom, you have all this field deployment. On the field, we connect it through networking. Offered via some platform solutions, existing platform solutions, where on top we apply these adapters, enablers, right? And they are exposed through the same APIs through the agriculture interoperability space. So you add to them the facilities, the core enabler facilities, or the optional facilities on the right hand side. And they are exposed with also uniform way, so you can compose your agriculture, agri, or livestock application. Okay. And so when you deploy this, so you have these entities, so the platform A, let's say platform B, where you have these enablers, these they talk with the interoperability space and the neighbor hub, and they're exposed. And they get this view from the developers and the stakeholders. When you deploy this solution, your application, you need somehow to connect that. So we have a microservices environment and at runtime. So where you have this, you expose your services and you expose your data pipelines for registration, discovery, provisioning, right? Typical solution. And if you want to see the way we are applying this and deploying that is, first we are going to while implementing the Demeter Enabler Hub, the marketplace, if you recall, and this major runtime environment, microservices-based service environment with Demeter Enabler enhanced entities. And this is the reference implementation. This will guide all further implementation. And then we expect that each of the pilots will more or less duplicate the service environment and they will bring in their own or existing Demeter enhanced entities, right? They will also connect with the Demeter Enabler Hub. So this is the pilot implementation. This is the typical case. We will allow also a more hybrid case for pilots who don't want to deploy too much infrastructure. They could use the reference implementation service environment. So they will use some components running in the central cloud and some components running in their own infrastructure. So we allow solutions are isolated on the platform, on the pilot infrastructure, or also combined more tied to the central solution. And the idea is that we can support with one proxy service environment, we can support multiple applications, but multiple broker service environments are allowed to connect to the hub, right? So there is no tie-in. And although we have one digital enabler hub in this project, if the business models require more for exploitation, let's say one per country to comply to country rules or whatever, we can technically support that. So the implementation Demeter is trying two things. It's trying to provide a concrete implementation through the reference implementation, but at the same time, allow a full flexibility for the business development. So I try to be very brief. I hope I succeeded. Thank you for your attention.